Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is Greg FPS, and welcome back to another gameplay commentary. Today, I'm actually going to be doing a commentary about the pros and cons of a digital copy of a game versus a physical copy of a game. And there's so many different pros and cons, and we've seen this become a lot more prevalent with the newer systems, especially the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4, because basically they allow you to pre-download games, and a lot of people are pre-ordering games and doing that sort of thing digitally. Now, so I want to kind of lay out the pros and cons for each one, and then you guys can comment down below which one you think is better. And honestly, it's all about personal preference, so you really can't be wrong. There's really no wrong answer you can put down in the comment section. So basically, what I'm going to be doing is just running through the pros and cons for each one, and then kind of giving my two cents on a few different topics that I will come across in this commentary. So let's start it off with the pros of the digital version of a game. So the first thing that I think is the most important is you get faster load times, and online play is a tad more streamlined. Like, there's a millisecond difference when you're playing on a game, because for example, if you're playing Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, it's going to take you a couple milliseconds to load the map when you're running or respawning and that sort of thing. Whereas if you have it all saved onto your hard drive on your Xbox or something like that, then it's just going to be able to pull it up faster. Honestly, it's a really, really minuscule difference, but those differences can mean like winning a gunfight or not in some certain circumstances. Next, you get the game as soon as it is released, and sometimes even before release, which is really cool. Now, T. Martin actually made a video about this before the release of Advanced Warfare. The day before, he said, if you change your time to Australian time, you can actually play the game earlier. Now, my friend lives in Australia. He's 14 hours ahead of me, so he could play the game 14 hours ahead. So if you set it to the same time, then basically that is another thing that could actually work. Now, I don't know if they fixed this, but it worked for a lot of people in Advanced Warfare. Fortunately, I had it early, so it didn't really matter to me. And also, guys, my friend downloaded The Witcher 3 onto the Xbox One. He was able to play it at 7:30 instead of 12 o'clock, which was pretty cool. I mean, definitely 4.5 hours is a huge improvement, which is really cool. Next, you also get some more built-in gaming content. For example, I pre-ordered Black Ops 3 on my Xbox One, so I got the Black Ops 3 camo for Advanced Warfare. You get those small incentives, whereas if you're actually getting a physical copy of the game, you can still get like different things. You know, you can get a keychain or that sort of thing, but it's just not digital most of the time. The next thing is you don't have to switch discs. That is definitely a huge thing that is really annoying, especially when you're playing multiple Call of Duties or something. You don't have to switch the disc. It's just a lot faster, works out a lot better. The next thing is there's no disc damage, so you can't scratch a disc, you can't break your disc in half, which, I mean, if you wanted to make a funny video, then maybe you'll want a physical copy if you want to break your game in half, but you can't get damage on the disc, which is also pretty cool. Next is game sharing. You can share your game with a couple of your friends, and you can have them have their primary account, your account, so then they can play on your games and you can play on their games. It's pretty cool. I've done it with a few friends. It's always nice to be able to have extra games that you didn't pay for, and you can also share like map packs and stuff too. And the last thing is digital will have patches built in, whereas if you get the disc, you have to install the new patch. So if you get a game, there's always a new patch usually every time you put it in a disc to install a game. Now, instead of having the entire game readily available, if you were to get it digitally, the patches would already be installed and it would go along with the install, whereas you'd have to do it separately if you actually put in a physical disc. Now, there are a few things that really, really suck about having the digital version. For example, you no refunds. There's no refunds. If you don't like the game, you are not able to return it. That's one thing. The next thing is it takes up a lot of storage. Now, there are a few consoles. I mean, I think the Xbox One and the PS4 both come standard with 500 gigabytes, and there are 1 terabyte versions as well. But the thing about it is if you get a full game that is made for next gen, it's going to be anywhere from like 40 to 80 gigabytes, which is a ton. That's gonna take up like a huge portion of your console overall. So if you have the digital version for like 5 games, then your console is pretty much full, and then you're gonna have to buy an external hard drive, which kind of sucks, kind of not the best thing. So let's get into the pros and cons about the physical copy of a game. So a pro is you have a physical copy that is yours. You don't have to worry about not having the game. If your account gets deleted, you'll have a physical copy of the game. Also, you have the ability to trade it in at GameStop. If you don't like the game, you can trade it in, get store credit for other games. You can bring it over to your friend's house and you can trade games with your friends. You can let them borrow it, that sort of thing. If you don't want to go the whole digital account sharing route, you can share your game and you can trade with your friends, that sort of thing. Also, limited edition with physical games come with different things. You know, you can get figurines or something similar, and usually they end up costing more for like a different version. I know in past Call of Duties they had like a hardened version, which came with like another CD with music or another booklet of like artwork and all that sort of stuff. So those sort of things. And the last thing is, the physical copy could be worth money in the future. You know, you see like Nintendo 64 games like Zelda, for example, people would pay like $80 right now on eBay for a physical copy of a Zelda Nintendo 64 game because they were worth more money. You know, eventually as you save things and they get older and older, usually they increase in price, unless it's like food or something, and then it would just decrease in price. So that's basically the pros and cons. I want to know what you guys think down in the comment section. So if you guys stayed to the end of the video, say what you like better. I mean, that's really what I want you guys to decide, because personally I think that digital is a little bit better than like a physical game because it loads up faster, it works faster, that sort of thing. But it's really up to you guys, and that's really what I wanted to touch on in this video, kind of get your opinion for it and lay out the pros and cons. So thanks again, whoever recommended this. I can't remember your name off Twitter right now, but I just want to say thank you for recommending this commentary topic. Really good one, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to drop it a like, and I'll see you guys later. My name is Greg FPS. Peace out.